We are joined now by Chris Christie, the former governor of New Jersey, Rahm Emanuel, the former mayor of Chicago, ABC News contributor Yvette Simpson, and Republican strategist Sarah Fagan. Joe Biden officially became the Democratic nominee tonight, and his wife, Dr. Jill Biden, in one of the few live speeches, talked about her husband's character. Yvette, certainly a tough act to follow after Michelle Obama last night. How'd she do?
You know, I think she did what she was supposed to do. She talked about her husband. She talked about their relationship, all things that people love to hear from a future first lady. She also talked about education, which, as you know, with kids going back to school, is a major issue. She talked about being able to fill those classrooms again. I think the big thing that was missing for me today, still, how are we gonna do it? If you're asking the question about Donald Trump, is he a disaster? We know the answer to that question. The question is, what is Joe Biden gonna do above and beyond the fact that Donald Trump is a disaster?
Governor Christie, your response.
Listen, I thought Dr. Biden did a great job tonight. I think it's going to be very difficult to compare people to Michelle Obama. It's not a fair thing to do. Jill Biden had a much different job tonight, as Michelle Obama had a much different job when she was campaigning with her husband to become first lady. But I thought the most powerful part of the entire speech tonight was the end, when Vice President Biden walked in and put his arm around his wife, and you could see the genuine affection between the two of them, and that's really a partnership. You know, one of the things that America wants in a challenging time like this, in a crisis, is they want people who they believe they can trust to lead them, and they saw a couple there tonight that clearly trust and love each other. Mm-hmm. That's a very, very powerful symbol, and quite frankly, I think more powerful than anything she said in her speech was that moment, because you can't fake that. And you could tell between the Vice President Jill Biden, it's real.
You had a former Democratic presidents Jimmy Carter and Bill Clinton, along with John Kerry and Caroline Kennedy, talking about Biden's leadership. And then you had 30-year-old Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. Mayor Emanuel, where does AOC fit in all of this?
Well, I mean, tonight is both the past and the future. You have a legacy, and I think the bigger piece is the values that emanate us as a party. And Jill touched on that he will treat your family the way he treats our family, and remembering that America is one giant family, that we care for each other. And so I think that she's part of the future. There was a diversity there, but also the common foundation and value system that we hold that emanate the policies that we propose, from family leave to global climate change to any one of those policies, I think, does that.
She barely got a minute of airtime tonight, pledging her support for her fellow progressive candidate, Bernie Sanders. Yvette, do you think that progressives like AOC are going to be able to bury the hatchet and unify the party?
I think we already have. I mean, the reality is most, a supermajority, far almost 100% of progressives support Joe Biden, are going to work and are already working together with the Biden campaign to make sure we deliver victory. I think the big question, and what people don't get about progressives, is that we're always fighting for a better future. That's why we're progressives. And so as much as we are excited about getting rid of Donald Trump, we know there is more work to do. We're a little disappointed by the fact that we're in the middle of a pandemic, we're in the middle of racial unrest, and we can't talk about health care in the way that we know that people need us to talk about health care. We're in the middle of a racial unrest, we can't talk about what we need to do to end the preschool to prison pipeline, to get rid of talk about the crime bill and how we need to make sure that we decarcerate our prisons. These are conversations that we would expect to be able to have in a year like this, but we're not. We're talking about what Donald Trump is or is not, which is a very big disappointment.
Can I just jump in? I apologize. In the end of the day, politically, it's about winning, and Donald Trump is the single greatest issue, and we want to make this a referendum on him.
We disagree about that.
I know we do.
We think that we still want people
on this one.
People want to vote for something, Rahm, and you know that.
I do.
And we already know that Donald Trump is a disaster. We don't need 4 days of that. We need to know what we're going to do to make people whole.
No, I'm from 4 days of making sure that Donald Trump, they know he's a disaster, and we have the answer to that problem.
Speaking of winning, Sarah, do you think that Joe Biden was able to win over any Republicans tonight?
Well, I think that the speech by Colin Powell, and then the video with Mrs. McCain narrating it, I think that was more powerful than last night. These are well-known figures. It's worth noting that Colin Powell has voted Democratic in the last at least two, maybe three presidential elections. He calls himself a Republican. He hasn't behaved like one. But look, there is about 12% of this country that are soft Republicans. They agree with Donald Trump's policies. They don't like his persona. That point tonight, that piece of the convention tonight, was really about saying to those soft Republicans, hey, you know, go with Joe Biden. It's okay to vote against Trump, even though you really like what he's doing on the economy and other things.
Well, and Lindsay, that's why I said earlier tonight that he's got to get back to talking about his policies. What the president needs to do next week is talk about his policies. That's the way he wins those people back that Sarah's talking about. If the Trump show next week is the Trump circus and all about persona, that's a loser for him. If he talks about the things he wants to do with four more years, I think that's the chance he has to draw those soft Republicans and independents back into his camp by setting that contrast. I think Rob's exactly right. If this is a referendum on Donald Trump, then Donald Trump is heading to a loss. If it's a binary choice between Joe Biden and Donald Trump, then I think we have a real race.
It's interesting. Both Barack Obama, Bill Clinton, and George Bush, 43, always made it a choice on the reelect. A reelect is not, what Donald Trump's problem right now is he's running 2016 and 2020.
Yep.
He has not updated his strategy for the 2020 election, which is it's a choice. All he had to do last time was say, what was wrong with her, what was wrong with Hillary Clinton. He's trying, when he went after Kamala Harris, he is trying to, he's running 2016 and 2020. Bill Clinton, George Bush, and Barack Obama made him clear on the reelect binary choices, and Donald Trump is still not figured out his handle on either Biden or Kamala Harris.
Sarah, I'll give you the last word, and we got to wrap.
We have had very little policy in this convention so far. Yvette is right. And it's hard to make it a choice when the Democrats only talk about the incumbent. I think it's a smart strategy. It's not sustainable. There will be a choice in the end.
Thank you so much to our I'm so sorry, Rahm Emanuel. We're out of time. We appreciate you joining us tonight. Night 2, now in the books.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.